CPAP and BiPAP systems provide positive airway pressure to patients through machines, tubing, and masks. Let's look closer at how this system works and the parts needed. CPAP and BiPAP machines have a fan that draws in air from the room. The air passes through filters that remove dust and other particles. A compressor then pressurizes the air at the set positive airway pressure. Because room air can be cold and dry, manufacturers offer optional humidifiers that are built in or attached to CPAP and BiPAP machines. Before the pressurized air is delivered to the patient, it passes through the humidifier. The air picks up moisture as it moves over a chamber filled with water. A heater below the chamber can be turned on and adjusted to warm the air for the patient's comfort. To prevent mineral buildup, it's important to use only distilled water in the humidifier. Air from the machine goes through tubing on its way to the patient. Tubing can be either heated or non-heated. Heated tubing keeps air warm as it travels and reduces condensation in the tubing. The temperature of the tubing can be adjusted on the machine. If the patient uses oxygen, an adapter is added to the tubing. This adapter allows the oxygen to mix with the air that is flowing to the patient. Some machines require a pressure valve to prevent oxygen from flowing back into the machine, which can cause a fire. The respiratory clinician will set up a pressure valve if needed. Air from the tubing enters the patient's airway and lungs through a mask. Masks usually have headgear to hold them in place and come in three main styles: nasal, nasal pillow, and full face. Nasal masks fit over the nose and are a good choice for a patient who sleeps with their mouth closed. Nasal pillow masks fit into the nostrils. These masks are popular with patients who find the nasal mask uncomfortable. They can also be used if the patient develops pressure sores or skin breakdown from other masks. Full-face masks cover both the nose and mouth. They are a good choice if the patient breathes excessively from their mouth or are awakened by air from the machine leaking into their mouth. To use a full face mask safely, the patient must be able to remove the mask on their own or have a caregiver monitoring them during use in case of vomiting or equipment failure. Chin straps are available to help patients keep their mouth closed. Like full face masks, the patient must be able to remove a chin strap on their own or have a caregiver monitoring them during use in case of vomiting or equipment failure. The doctor or a respiratory clinician fits the patient for a mask. If the patient's CPAP or BiPAP mask no longer meets their needs, call their physician or durable medical equipment provider for available options.